I'm going to try and document starting a new synthpop track pretty much from scratch until I have a recognizable composition that I'm happy with, and that eventually I'll move on to the computer to finish up and add any extra production that I feel necessary. Alright, so I'm just going to get going. There's going to be some commenting, lots of knob twiddling, lots of button presses. Try to follow along. Okay, so this button allows me to select the sound engine. These are 8 quick load slots for 8 different kinds of sounds. Number one, I have a sort of bell kind of sound. It's quite powerful. But I want to mess it up. So, let's go. A little bit of brightness on the blue knob. I like that. Oh, I like these overtones. I like these, I'm gonna try that one. That I like. Effects section. So these 4 buttons allow me to access synth parameters, envelope, effects section. Shift allows me to then select which effect I want. In this case, I'm gonna go for the phone effect, which adds a dial-up feel, like dial-up modem feel to the sound. Number 4 is the LFO. I have several LFOs. Right now I'm going to go to the value LFO. First knob is speed. See, something like that. That's good. Okay, the amount, and then the destination. I'm going to send it to the effects, so that the phone effect. And then this allows me to set which parameter. So I don't know which one, which color is which, so I'm just going to listen. I like that. Yep. So I'm just going to keep it that way. And ultimately, I don't have to press anything. It's just set that way. That's it. Done. Awesome. Okay. Next sound that I have, slot 2. This is the phase engine. Pretty happy with it. This is the cluster engine. Okay. pulse engine. At this point, I prepared a sequence that is going to drive this synth. So this is the endless sequencer, where you essentially are able to record as many steps as you want, from 1 to, I think, 256 steps. So it's kind of like a mix of a sequencer and an arpeggiator. I think that's going to be a recurring theme in the track that I want to make. I'm going to turn it off. So this is a Dr. Wave, nice for bass sounds. Pulse again. I'll turn that off. Kind of rough sounding. I'm going to tweak this one as well. First off, I'm going to turn off the effect. Back to the synth section. Okay, that's okay. Okay, the modulation may be a little bit too strong. Okay, that'll do for now. Envelope, a little bit more attack. Okay, now the effect. I think I'm gonna go for a spring reverb. That sounds good. All right. This is the digital engine, I think. Let's see. Yep, digital. Okay. Okay, I like that. And last but not least, this is a sample. Let's see if we can make it sound less natural. Interesting. Okay, we have a spring reverb again as the effect. Might be interesting to use the LFO here to affect the sample playback a little bit. Thank you. Maybe. Let's see. I like that. Kind of more of a delicate sound. Okay, I'm happy with that. So I think I'm going to stop here for today. These are the sounds that I'm going to try to use to make the song. Until next time, good night and good luck.